This is something Melissa would freaking love, but I don't really want a fifth wheel again. Let's go take a look. This thing is super interesting. It's four-wheel drive, so I'm into it. Here's a super interesting rig that our actual good friends, Jason and Ray, the Getaway Couple, have. Y'all, Jesse here with Adventure Endeavor. And today, believe it or not, we are back in Quartzsite, Arizona. Today, we are gonna be going to the Quartzsite RV show. So I have never been before. I've been to Quartzsite many times and we just happened to be here during the show. So we figured, why not go? Why not go tour a few rigs, kind of get an overall feel and vibe of what this show is about. So I'm gonna be going with my buddy Scott. And we're gonna go down there, maybe walk through the big tent, maybe tour a couple rigs. Let us know down in the comments if you've ever been here before and what you thought of it. We're going into this completely blind. I've never been, I'm by myself. Melissa is on her way to Hawaii. We're gonna go scope it out. Here at the first one that really caught my eye. It's a fifth wheel. It is a 364 BHL. This is something Melissa would freaking love, but I don't really want a fifth wheel again. Let's go take a look. So from the outside, obviously a nice big underbelly. It has two doors. It has one here and has one in the back. Let's go take a look at this bad boy. All right, interior, super nice. Light, bright. You have a dinette, obviously that goes down to a bed. You got dual couches, nice big island. There are opposing slides here. Obviously you can tell. Big fridge, I think it's a three-way. Fireplace down here, nice big TV. This is what I know Melissa would love, but I don't want something this big. You got a massive bunkhouse up here with a lower bed, nice big windows, nice big closet. Ladder up to the top. And then you actually have a half bath with a door. Super spacious. High ceiling with a fan. So this rig has two toilets. This is a really nice rear bunk. And then you got a ton of storage here. The white is really nice in here, cream, whatever you want to call it. And then you have your standard kind of fifth wheel master, corner shower, another toilet, I believe a queen bed with a pop out. This is a super nice layout. Front windows, kind of nice. So I would have to admit, this is a nice rig. When we got rid of our toy hauler, in my head, I was like, if we're getting another fifth wheel, I wanted something with this type of layout to where there was a nice bunk area. We debated converting ours into a bunk area, but this thing is super nice. Good thing Melissa's not here. She'd want to buy it right now. Here's a super interesting rig that our actual good friends, Jason and Ray, the Getaway Couple, have. I think this is obviously just newer, but this is a Solitude ST, Solitude 346 FLS. So let's check it out. This is interesting. So you come in and you have your kitchen. You have a dinette, which is a slide here, slide on the other side. Nice big kitchen, tons of counter space. Storage underneath. What is this? Steps up to the front. Massive front living room. I always love these front living rooms. They're so unique. So you have a fireplace. Your TV pops up here, which is cool. And I'm sure these go into beds as well. Lots of storage. This is a big trailer. I think this is like over 40 foot. And then the rear goes up as well, which is super interesting. Nice big shower, fancy shower. Check that out. Shower is sweet. Toilet, nice big bedroom. Big old closet, I think it's prepped.
Super cool layout. But what is the coolest thing about this rig
is the rear. So we're gonna go to the rear cargo area right now.
This is why they do the raised rear bedroom. Massive slide out cargo tray with storage bays on both sides. So you have so much storage in here. It is insane.
That is a super sweet setup.
And then obviously in the front, you still have your standard fifth wheel underbelly storage up front here.
Oh, it's a little bit smaller,
but still a lot of storage.
Super cool rig. It's also $140,000, and it's also like over 40 feet. So not for me, but it's cool. I like it. All right, guys, I know nothing about Class A's. My nice friends here told me that this is the one I should tour. This is an Integra Cornerstone. Let's go check it out. All right, here we go. White leather, that's what I want. I feel like we're in a Las Vegas casino, I'm not gonna lie. There's a lot of fancy lights everywhere. This is weird. It's not my cup of tea. Ugh. It feels a little outdated. Half bath. It is very spacious though. This comforter, excellent. Ceiling fan. This thing is, I don't know. Dual sinks. Closet. Oh, there's two toilets. Nice big shower. It's just super weird. The coloring is not my cup of tea. The layout's not terrible though. Nice big couch to hang out at. TV. Fridge. What do you guys think? This thing is super interesting. It's four-wheel drive, so I'm into it. Except it's a Ford, so I'm not that into it.
Maybe with the lift kit wheels and tires.
Yeah.
So this basically to me is like a crew cab with a cab over camper built onto it.
Okay. Rear bed pop out. That is super weird. It's spacious though. Big bed.
Come on, this is what I gotta convince the wife to get. This thing is sweet.
Look at, you just come right in here.
How much? I want it. Could get one of these and then flat tow the Wagoneer behind it. Oh, it comes with beer cans too. Not bad. Not bad at all, guys.
What do you think, guys? Buy this and then flat tow the Jeep. Yes or no? Let us know in the comments.
Outside thing. It's a hard-sided fold-out, which I like more than tent, but that would get annoying, I think. A lot of storage. Definitely a cool little rig, though, for what it is. I think they
got something going, right?
They're just
not quite there, though. They're not quite there, though. Right?
The cart's in the right place.
Well, four-wheel drive, like, you kind of... You hook me there a little bit, you know? But I'd like to see it with a Cummins, personally.
Whoa. All right, we're going the executive. Touring this bad boy.
1987, boys and girls.
Comes with a mural. 87? Wow, this is my vintage, guys. Why is there like clear curtains? That seems very weird.
It's got the original mattress.
Look at this, it's nice.
Floral print house.
You know what's funny is it smells like my parents' 86 Southwind. It has the same smell.
Look at this.
Wow. pretty nice. No slides though. I don't know.
Slides weren't invented yet.
Ew. It's gross. It's gross. I can't go in there.
Don't go in there.
Did you open the bathroom?
Yeah, don't go in there. It's gross.
Never open the bathroom.
The floor is very soft right there. It's probably not good.
I think that one will be a pass. There's another option. 31 MB. Reflection. Grand design. Mid bunk. Going in. You walk straight into a massive mid bunk.
That's pretty nice, actually.
A lot of space. Then you can go into the kitchen.
Big ass dinette.
Big A
dinette. This is a pretty sweet layout.
Pretty sweet layout. $88,000. Then you come up here. What do we got here? Bathroom. Typical. Typical. Melissa would probably like this one too.
It's also pretty long.
Today was great, but it was also kind of a failure because we didn't realize that the big tent technically wasn't open yet. So we toured some RVs, showed you guys some cool layouts, but I'm probably not gonna go back, not gonna lie. It's gonna be crazy busy tomorrow. That's it, hope you guys enjoyed this video of kind of touring the Quartzsite RV show, but not really. Bye.